Hi everyone, my name is Nate Clinton. I'm a program manager on the Outlook team, and today I'm going to walk you through how Outlook Mobile is bringing you capabilities to help you get organized. First, we'll start with a quick look back, and then we'll spend some time talking about some of the great stuff that's coming up, and then I'll do a quick demo in between. At the end, make sure to check out some of the related sessions. There's some great stuff there from Outlook about time and management, search, security, contacts, and more, so definitely check it out. Before we get on to what's new, let's take a quick look back. When we last met up, we spoke about a lot of great experiences coming to Outlook for iOS and Android. Delegate mailboxes, native phishing and spam reporting, tasks, S/MIME, Play My Emails for Android. We're happy to report that they've all shipped. We are super excited about these features and we can't wait to hear what you think of them. Your feedback helps energize us, so please keep it coming. Now let's go on to what's new. As we think about how to bring the best experiences to Outlook mobile users, one theme stays consistent, and that is keeping you connected to what matters. We want to help you connect to your email, calendar, contacts, files, bringing you the best of Office 365. We want to help you get organized by helping you stay on track and prioritizing your day. And of course, we are committed to continuing to be the gold standard for secure mobile communications by protecting your privacy, keeping you safe, and putting you in control of your sensitive data. We'll go through each area and I'll highlight some of the great work that has or will be done in Outlook Mobile, and then I'll do a quick Outlook demo on the new Surface Duo in between. If there's an important takeaway from this session, it should be our commitment to making investments to help you keep on top of what's important to you, and as your personal organizer, reduces the effort to balance your time and help you to get things done in a safe and secure way. This is a journey, but we hope you're as excited as we are on the progress that's being made here. Now let's talk how Outlook keeps you connected to the rest of M365. You can see we're connecting to Teams where it matters. Up next, to your Teams chats, upcoming in search, and from your meeting invites. You can also change the setting to have every meeting you create be an online meeting. This is another step in helping you prepare for what's up next and in keeping you productive while online. If you don't use Teams, we have extended our online meetings integration to enable top providers like WebEx, Zoom, BlueJeans, GoToMeetings, and several more. Any of these can be made your default meeting provider. And we continue to bring you great new Office Lens functionality in Outlook Mobile. With Inking, you can mark up images you've taken, and with Gallery, you have your recent images at a glance with your media right where you need it. Definitely stay tuned for more great lens functionality coming to Outlook Mobile. We are also continually trying to improve the experience of composing and sending email. With suggested replies, we make it easy for a quick response. And on iOS, we are working on extending suggested replies to include quick actions like send availability and scheduling a meeting. With text predictions, we help finish your sentences. Just swipe to insert the recommended text and save time. Of course, as your personal organizer, Outlook connects you to the tasks in M365. To create tasks, you can flag emails, or now you can create a task from the message. Plus, in your search landing page, you now have the top three tasks from to-do. You can mark them complete, or you can go directly to the to-do app to do that. And with Play My Emails on iOS, you can now add directly to your to-do list. Finally, we'll make it easy to get the app on your phone if you don't already have it. Today, with sign-in, Outlook on the web makes it easy for you to get started with Outlook for iOS or Android. You send yourself a text message, you install the app, and you enter in your username and password. With simplified app sign-in, the friction of typing in your username and password when signing into Outlook Mobile is removed. You install the app, you scan the QR code that Outlook on the web will display, and you are done. Seamlessly and securely authenticating the user, getting them quickly up and running, is key. It helps with scale deployments, it'll help facilitate adoption, and it'll reduce help desk load. This is coming soon to Outlook on the web and Outlook for Windows as well. And all of this, by the way, will help you not only get signed into Outlook, but will also help you get signed into Office, OneDrive, and other Microsoft 365 mobile experiences through SSO. Finally, in the Connect space, I want to talk about the Watch. There's some great new functionality coming to Outlook Mobile Watch experiences. On iOS, we are introducing calendar colors, free busy indication, new complications, a new home screen, and a look at what's coming tomorrow, helping you to be prepared. On Android, Outlook is now built into your Samsung wearables so that you can stay a step ahead with everything you need at a glance. In the first version, we released a way for you to browse, reply, and triage emails on the go. And now we are working on getting the topmost user requested features like showing your calendar events on your watch. Great, now you're connected. Let's talk about how Outlook Mobile helps you stay organized. You have contacts, mail, events, documents, a ton of stuff. So in partnership with Microsoft Search, we're able to bring a much improved and rich search experience to Outlook Mobile. For example, natural language search helps you get your stuff naturally through text or voice. And when you search, you're now able to get relevant answers that are actionable, like a phone number or a meeting join option. Some of what's coming next for search includes pagination and file answers, plus a ton more. And coming next for voice is commanding, where you can use your voice for core Outlook scenarios such as compose an email, schedule a meeting, or connect with or call someone. The recommended feed has also gotten better. You'll notice SharePoint news and recorded meetings in the feed, and you'll be able to drill into the feed with a new full page view. This gives you quick access to important documents, news, and meeting recordings from your organization. There is a ton of great information in the search session, so please go check it out. They'll talk about these types of things, plus much more. Contacts are also an important investment area for the team. Support for sorting your contacts by last name, being able to designate an account as your default for contact creation. And then we're also working on contact categories. For a while, you've been asking for contact folder syncing, but syncing folders would result in duplicated contacts. So with contact categories, your folders will appear as categories, no duplications, just complete syncing of your contacts and easy filtering of those contacts. We also have a session on contacts where we will go into more detail for these and other things, so definitely check it out. With actionable notifications, you'll be able to customize your notifications to your heart's content. You can customize by going to Settings, Mail Notifications, Custom Actions, and then you can choose from 5 custom actions like Flag or Mark as Read. And then with Time Suggestions, we're making it easier to find time that works. You're provided suggested times and can adjust through settings to fine-tune. And we've made it easier to ensure you'll be able to reserve a place to get work done. There is a lot of great stuff coming to the time management space. So again, check out their session also. They'll talk about these things plus more. Finally, with drag and drop, we have exciting features coming your way for iOS and for Android. Here you can see files and photos being dragged from the iOS Files app into a message. For Android, I'll show you in a few seconds when I run through the demo.
Okay, let's get started with the demo of Outlook on Surface Duo. The first thing you'll notice on Duo is that we have 2 entry points. We have the Outlook icon on the left, and then we also have a calendar icon in the upper right. The icon on the left, the Outlook icon, will take you directly to your inbox, just as it does today, and the calendar icon takes you directly to your calendar, of course. With both of these instances open, you can switch tabs and set up any combination of the 2 Outlooks side by side that you'd like. So you can have 2 instances with your inbox open. You can have 2 instances of search, of calendar, a combination. So lots of flexibility, and I'll show a little bit of that as I go through. But let's start by going into the Outlook icon, and we're looking at Rosie's message list. So let's go through how she might triage these with the Duo. So with the first one, she is being asked to schedule something on an online meeting for Friday. So let me go ahead and check my calendar so I can come in here. I can go into calendar. I can meet it in span so I can have a nice big view. This is the month view, of course, and it looks like I was super busy last week, but not so much this week. I can go into the week view as well, just to confirm, yep, nothing going on. And I can also go into the day view or the agenda view, and here I can see my items on the left and on the right, the details for this selected item. But I don't really have much going on, so I don't have anything to select. So let me go back into email. And here you'll see the spanned view of email, and I can select that email again, and I'll see it on the right. No problem setting it up, so I'll use quick reply and say, yep, works for me, and I'll send it along. So I'm all set with that one. So let me look at the next one. This is from Emily. Emily has a list of tasks or items she wants me or my team to help with for the Northwind project. Okay, no problem. So this looks like a good job for to do. So I can keep these and mark them off later. So let me open up to do. And in my email, I will select all the items. Let me just grab them and select them. And then I can drag them from Outlook into to do. And now I have all those items there and I can come back to them later and mark them off. So that's great. Helps me stay organized and be productive. I'm going to close out of there. So that's two that are taken care of now. So let me look at this third one. The latest copy of the new product pricing document. I think I have that in, Rosie has it in her OneDrive. So let me open up a new instance. So I'll open up Calendar. And I could also do this from OneDrive. You'll see me dragging and dropping stuff. And we've done a lot of drag and drop work in Android and iOS. But on for Duo, you'll see us doing it between different apps, OneDrive, Teams, OneNote, To-Do, of course, so on. So it's pretty cool. So let me open up Calendar. And as I mentioned, it goes directly into the calendar view, but I could switch it to email. In this case, I want to go to search because I want to look at my files. So I'm going to look up, I'm going to go into the files. I'm going to select my OneDrive. And I think it's the Contoso purchasing data. So let me just say, yep, here you go. Let me open that up. I'm going to grab the Contoso purchasing data and bring it in. I think I can either insert it as a link or I can drop it as an attachment. I think I'll attach it. And I'll send it, and I'm good to go. So let me go ahead and back out of that. So again, you can see that I have flexibility here to switch to whatever view I want side by side with these two instances. I have my email here, my email on the other side. But let me see if there's anything else here for me to take a look at. I have something from Alex here. Go ahead and close that out. They want me to review this. No problem. So let me open it up. So I click on it. And it opens up in the Office app. Super fast. In the Office app, I can do all kinds of things that you'd expect from Office. I can take a look at it. I can review, edit, share. Looks good to me. So I will close this out. And I think I want to do a little more typing here. So I'm going to reply. Oops. Maybe I'll start with saying will do. And I'll go to the full view. And I can turn the device, and now I have a much bigger keyboard on the bottom, and I can use it kind of like a laptop. So I can say, will do, looks great, so far, I'll let you know. And I'll send that off, and that is my inbox triaged. Lots of cool stuff happening in both Android and iOS. On Duo, you can see that we're really utilizing the two screens and we'll continue to do more in that space. We'd love to hear your feedback as you start to use these and get familiar with them. But there's a lot of cool stuff that can be done with these two screens and we're excited to see what's possible. Thanks. Let's get back to the slides.
All right. I hope you enjoyed the demo. Now let's talk about getting things done in enterprise. We know that getting things done with trust and security is a top priority, both for you and for us, and we remain focused in this space. With shared mailboxes, You're able to discover and add shared mailboxes and remove them, and then you're able to also read, compose, and send from shared mailboxes. And then earlier this year, we added full access for Delegate Mailbox that administrators can manage. Delegate Mailbox for end user permissions, for example, extending permissions to another user to mail on my behalf, is on its way. We continue to make improvements to combating spam through report junk option, which is now available. And then you can clearly differentiate between the accounts you've added in the app. When you have more than one account, you'll see the account icon when you create a new message or a new event to let you know which account you're in. And we are also working on providing the ability for your admin to set a branded company logo to use as the icon. With work personal separation, we show you the contacts for the account you are in first, and then make it clear more results are available in different accounts, and you need to take a deliberate action to get to those contacts in those different accounts. We continue to invest in sensitivity labeling, with manual labeling available now and auditing and mandatory labeling coming soon. And then with SMI, we made several improvements here, including the ability to set email to always sign and always encrypt, ability to view installed SMIME certificates and certificate status, the ability to view SMIME certificate details, and the ability to remove certificates if they aren't being delivered by Intune. And then finally, more support for BYOD, app protection, app configuration, conditional access. We continue to have a close partnership with Intune, helping to ensure that we provide the most needed support for BYOD. Thank you all so much for watching today. I hope you got a good picture of how we think about getting you organized with Outlook Mobile. Here are a list of the different sessions to go check out. You should. There's lots of great information here that covers a lot of what I covered, but much, much more. And again, we appreciate your feedback, so keep it coming. Thanks.